What's going on, everybody, and welcome back to Cedar Flags, where in this episode we will be putting down a flat ride and then doing some decorating around it, but that's not all we're going to do. We're also going to work on that lighting issue that we have pretty much neglected for, I don't know, most of this series. So yeah, stay tuned for that. We're also going to go in the live portion and check out what we named the drink stand from last time. And I think that's pretty much everything we're going to do in this episode. But next episode, we are definitely going to be designing another roller coaster, and I know a bunch of you guys are going to be excited for that, so stay tuned for that. But first things first, we finally have another ride in the park. It seems like forever since we last put a ride down, and of course this is just a flat ride, but it's gonna kind of serve a couple purposes here. It's a little bit more intense than I think most of our rides, beside maybe Alpine Spirit. But this is also the tallest ride in the park now, and it's actually taller than our roller coaster, which is kind of interesting. I don't know what that says about our roller coaster, but whatever. You'll notice it kind of we're starting to kind of shape the skyline of Cedar Flags. It's kind of starting to look like a proper theme park now, which is obviously the goal of this series. But yes, so what we're doing right now with these art blocks is trying to create some sort of shade for the queue path that you saw me put down. And this is kind of interesting. Like, I think in a real park, you'll see a lot of theme parks try to really focus on putting the queue either hidden away from the general public, so you kind of don't realize how long of a line there is for a ride before you hop into the line. But it's also to try to keep the people out of the sun. And in this little plot of land that we're using, there's nothing around it. So it's wide open, the sun's hitting people directly in the face, and you don't want that because the sun will, you know, exhaust people and more tired people will leave the park earlier. And from a theme park point of view, that's not good because they're not spending their money in your park. So what we're trying to do here is create some sort of shade. You'll see real parks do this with a variety of different things, just like artificial roofs and different things. But this, what we're trying to create here, is kind of like you'd see more of like a mesh tent type thing. I think I actually Googled like theme park shade for the basis of this design. But yeah, I saw a lot of like mesh or fabric tent material, just it looked like a sail almost. And I wanted to recreate that. So these art shapes are, they're a little finicky. You saw me put the kind of the test one together, and then I ended up putting these lights down. And these lights are serving a couple purposes here. It's a bit of a design aspect, I guess, but B, it's allowing for a little bit of variability in this design. You'll see right now, actually, that the art blocks aren't actually touching each other. So with these kind of cables on the sides of this, it kind of gives that, like, it's okay because they're all strung onto this cable instead of together. So from like a very, I guess, minuscule like perspective, that's kind of what those are achieving. They're also giving us a place to kind of tether all of this to these posts that we're kind of doing right now. Before with the art blocks, we had to just kind of get those right. And with these little cables off at the end, it makes it look like they're tied up. So it gives us a little bit more leeway in designing. And that's always something that I guess you want to try to do if you have to in this game. But you saw me right there take the metal pole down into the ground. I was originally going to use that pole as kind of the basis of this design, but it wasn't tall enough. And the other wooden, I think those are wooden pillars, the one is really tall, so that's a really good thing. And I didn't want to like mismatch those. I wanted all of those pillars to look the same. So we sunk the one all the way to the ground. It's still there because this now still counts as an actual building. And we can use this as a blueprint like I did, and then go ahead and just duplicate this over and over. Speaking of this as a blueprint, this will be up in the Steam Workshop. So you guys can go ahead and download this along with the save. All of the save files from this series have been up to date in the Steam collection. So if you ever want to get a little piece of this, or continue this park from where I've left off from a certain episode, go ahead and click on the Steam Workshop link that is always in the description under that like button. But right now, what we're doing is just kind of throwing these together. A lot of times with this specific kind of design, I guess, you'll see kind of, I guess, it's not really uniform. It's kind of just abstracted, I guess, is a word that you could use. But yeah, I just tried to throw these at different angles, try to kind of maximize the amount of shade. You'll actually notice there's a lot of shade over a majority of the queue right now, which is obviously the target of this whole thing. But yeah, what we're doing is kind of trying to throw these under each other, vary the height a little bit, vary the angle, just to make it look like this whole thing is kind of just that abstract art in a sense. So yeah, this whole thing kind of accomplishes a lot more than just creating shade, which is really cool. But yeah, we've actually taken a couple of those and made them taller and actually changed one angle completely so it's a little steeper than the other ones. And that's just something you want to do to create something interesting, like, to the eye. If they were all pretty much uniform, it'd just be like boring and bland. But I think after you kind of create a couple different looking points, I guess you could say, it makes this whole design look a lot cooler. So just finalizing all of the placement here, and then we're gonna have to go through and actually continue detailing this whole kind of area. Now, I didn't really know what to do around here because it is just a piece of grass, you know? This is all we had to work with. There's not much nature here. So I tried to cut the paths as close as I could to the existing paths that we had set up. You'll actually see, you'll see Silverette do this a lot. He'll just kind of cut paths really close together. It kind of creates awkward kind of segments and like little tinier grass, I guess, areas. But he'll go through and kind of detail that out a little bit and make it look cool. So that's kind of what I was going for here. Not saying I stole Silverette's design at all, but I'm not nearly as good at this game as he is. But yeah, it was kind of interesting because it takes a little bit more. Well, it gives people a way to walk around the area a little bit more, and you could get that direct path to exactly where you want to go. But this also made it so we didn't have to detail a large area of just grass. Now, that isn't always the easiest thing to do, and especially in this area where there's no real true theming going on. So I don't know. It also gave us a really good area to put some more. You'll see me right now putting a bunch of trash cans and then a couple more of the benches around. So after that was all done, we went through and did a couple things with some rocks here. Now, I do this a lot with these rocks, and that is just kind of sink them into the ground. So they're pretty low looking rocks and they kind of all merge into each other. So I think this adds a little bit of interest around this area. I'm not so sure that it fits around here, but then again, I wasn't really sure what else to do in this area. So I did want to just kind of get some nature into this little small area. I guess in one sense, it does kind of still fit over here because that whole kind of cliffside that Alpine Spirit is running through is kind of right there. So I think we could kind of tie this all together a little bit more when we further develop this side of the park. Now, again, I mentioned a little earlier that we are not going to be doing that in the next episode. Next episode, we will probably be designing the, I think, dive coaster is what I've settled on. And that is going to go more toward the row houses. So we're kind of bouncing back and forth in this series from side to side in the park. And I don't know, I guess that's a good way to do it because we are still very, very early on in this park. There's not a ton of things going on, but, you know, we just have to knock it out one thing at a time. Just keep going through and keep designing and stuff. And I really love this game, I have to say. I just don't play it nearly as much as I should or as I want to even. So right now we're going through with some more bushes and then some more rocks. And I think this is pretty much it for this. And after this, we had to go through and do some lighting. Now this is where it gets a little bit more interesting again. The lighting that I wanted to do under this, you kind of see it already. I wanted to take these little shade triangular structures and make them kind of day-night, like interesting in different like lights, I guess you could honestly say. So by day, it's just this abstract kind of thing that provides shade, but at night, it turns into this whole colorful array of just art, I guess. So yeah, you're seeing me go ahead and placing the lights down. Now, I always try to stay as realistic as I can, so I really don't like sinking the lights down under the ground so you can't see them. But then again, like this game, we, in real life, you'd have kind of spotlights that would probably go into the path work, or even, I guess, be a different way of reflecting from the post. Now, the lights that we're using right here are huge. They're spotlights like you'd find on a stage. So it was kind of really tough to try to work that into like a proper like aesthetic. So in the end, I did kind of drop them under the ground, which I don't want to say I'm justifying it, but at the same time, I'm kind of justifying it. What we're doing right now, now that that was all done, is creating a little bit of like a pseudo lamppost, I guess you could say. Right here, it's right next to a bunch of people, and I just wanted to create something because I didn't like the way that the lampposts that we have, the like street lights that are in this game by default, I don't like how those look. Those are kind of like a city theme that I'm not going for in this park. And so this, I wanted to create something that's just gonna illuminate a wide area of the park. And this was it. I just came up with this small looking thing. It kind of looks like a trash can if you look at it from a distance, I guess. But if you look up close, it really does look like, I guess, some sort of beacon light or something like that. So yeah, we just go ahead, go through the park and switch it over to nighttime, and then line these around the paths. And in the end, it really comes out great. There's so much light that's emitted from this. And once again, this blueprint will be on the Steam Workshop in the collection, so you guys can add this. I think it's a very discreet way of lighting up your main paths without having this huge overhead of like a giant structure. So yeah, this is it. Let's go ahead and go live into Cedar Flags and see what we just did. All right, guys, so here we are in the live portion, and as you can tell, this ride is extremely tall compared to even Alpine Spirit over there. So let's go ahead and zoom out here and check it from the front of the park, which is actually something I did as I was considering what ride to place there. So yeah, you can tell we finally start to have somewhat of a, I guess, theme park feel, even though you could get that by looking to the right of the main entrance here. But yeah, we should continue to grow that upwards, and yeah, it's probably gonna be pretty cool in the end, I think, right? I don't know. Okay, so while we're over here, let's go check out what we did in the last episode, and we've actually named this the Cedar Valley Brewing Company. Now, Cedar Flags is the park name. I know Cedar Valley kind of has nothing to do with this, but I do kind of like the idea of having Cedar Valley as like the, I don't know, like the Western kind of outlaw style areas of the park could be under the Cedar Valley brand. It sounds like something that you'd see in like a park. I know Cedar Flags, for instance, has their Cedar Creek kind of theme around, so we could definitely use this. It also kind of ties into the other series that's running on my channel. But for those of you who are probably asking, how in the hell did he get two lines of text on one sign? Well, it's pretty simple. This is actually two signs, and you just can't tell from far back. I'll bet you couldn't tell up till now. Yeah, there are two signs on this, and if I get out of this display here, if I move this one, you'll see that it's actually the second one's back there. So yeah, if you didn't know this, you can actually sync signs into each other and just the text will pop out for the most part. Let me just undo this a couple times here. But yeah, the outline was still there, and having that in white was actually kind of strange to look at. So I tried to disguise that as much as possible, and from a distance you can't even tell, but it does. It looks like it's meant to be two lines of text. So that came out really, really awesome, and I thank whoever had the Cedar Valley idea, and I think I may have merged a couple of ideas for that actually. But anyway, back to what we were doing in this episode, and that was the Screaminator. And they're somewhere going up here. I think a couple rides may have passed in the time that we kind of took to talk about all that. But yeah, you can see all of the people here are under the shade of this whole kind of abstract art-styled shade givers. I honestly don't know what these should be called. They may have a technical term, and if they do, somebody let me know. But yeah, they are doing their job, and at night they look awesome, but before I switched this over to night mode, I did kind of want to talk about a little bit of what we did here. And it was just to kind of give all of this grassy area somewhat of a feel of, I guess, nature. So yeah, everything in this park so far has a lot of nature around it. And like I said, in the time lapse, this was kind of a challenge because there was a lot of empty space around here. So I love having these paths here to kind of, I guess, give a little bit more of a, or a little less rather, confined space here. But yeah, the rocks are something that right now kind of look out of place because they're just kind of randomly in this one square of, I say square loosely, this one little area of a ride here. But I think we can kind of take this whole kind of cliffside and incorporate this over here a little bit more. You'll notice that this is actually pretty blank right here, and that's by design. I kind of wanted to tie this side of the path into whatever we theme over here. Why are you thinking of quitting? You know what? I'll deal with you later. But yeah, I don't know. I think when we kind of develop this out more, we might do a little bit more terraforming around here and maybe have this the start of the kind of Western cowboy theme or style around here. We'll have like a whole themed area kind of out here or something. We'll do something with that. It should be pretty fun. But yeah, I think that's pretty much it. Let's go ahead and turn this over to night. And yeah, you'll see we actually have a lot of lighting going on here, which is something that we've been lacking for the most part throughout this playthrough. Now, there are definitely areas that still need to be lit. I like having this kind of plaza a little more dim and just having the light from the fountains kind of carry this whole area. I think it makes like this really intimate feel surrounded by a lot of just like busy theme park. And you can tell there's not a tremendous amount of people sitting around here. And that's probably because they don't really need to, because there are benches throughout the park. But it'd be nice to put some like functioning tables down here. Hint, hint. But yeah, we still need to kind of go ahead and light up this area, light up a lot of this interior stuff that we've been working on, and this whole back alley. There's really not much going on over here except our chandelier, which has one lonely light there. And oh wow, those stars actually light up. That is really cool. I didn't know that when I placed those. But yeah, you'll notice over here that from the daytime to the nighttime, these actually take a fully separate look. Now they're colored underneath, and it adds some interest, and it also adds something. Like, I don't know if you've been to theme parks much, but if you go to a theme park, you kind of get lost throughout the day in the theme park. And I think walking in down this main path during like the daytime, you'd see like this white structure here, and then later on when it's nighttime, like it is right now in the game, and you're walking out of the theme park, you'll kind of look over and be like, wow, this is really different, or something looks strange, or I didn't notice this at first. You know, it kind of adds that little bit of flair just because they're kind of a different color at night. But yeah, that's pretty much all we had to talk about in this episode. Now again, I said the next episode is going to be a coaster themed episode, not a theme, but a coaster build, and that is what's going to happen. So stay tuned for that, guys. This is going to go over here, probably somewhere around there. But yeah, guys, stay tuned for that. I know a lot of you are excited for that. I am too, because it's been so long since I've designed a coaster in this game. It's kind of ridiculous. But yeah, if you liked this episode, go ahead and give me a thumbs up on it. If you disliked it, give me a thumbs down. Any thoughts, go in the comments about anything in this episode or in the next coaster build. So guys, until next time, I will be back here designing away in Cedar Flags.